I threw this platter a few days ago. It's leather hard. Actually, it's leather hard on the harder side of leather hard. I prefer to trim a bit softer, but a lot of times if you put a large platter on when it's fairly soft, there's a lot of weight between here and here, and they'll slump. So this is firmed up enough to hold its to hold itself up. I have it on the bat. Just moisture holds this on the bat. I have just some water on the bat, on the rim of the platter. It keeps it stuck, and I've leveled it. A lot of time when you're throwing, the bats aren't completely level, and the bat you're trimming on isn't level, so there's always a little bit of play in there. But you want to make the bottom when you're trimming completely level, so if it touches all the way around with the needle, it's level. If it touches only a little bit, it'll show where the low spots are. Lift them up and put a bit of clay under it until the needle touches all the way around, you know it's level, and then you want it centered. Again, I'm only going to center when I'm trimming. I'm only trimming from here up and level from there down. So it doesn't matter if the rest of the platter is not completely centered because I'm not trimming the rest of the platter. I'm going to use a little Kemper tool. I've used this shape forever. It is, I think it's a Kemper K4, but I've used it for so long I buy it by shape and not by number. It's a great little tool. If it's comfortably in your hand, you have a hold of it, and it's a ribbon tool, meaning it ribbons are thinner and they cut better. The wire tools are I prefer not to use them. They're rounder and they don't cut, they're kind of going through like a plow. So I'm just going to hold on to my tool, my elbows on my knee, my arms into my ribs, my hands are joined, and I'm going to start cutting this platter. I don't like to put the rim, the foot on the platter that I do in the bowl. When I trimmed the bowl, I gave it what I called a presence. And this one, I like it to sit flat on the table, easy for me to say. And just sort of become one of the table. So I don't do a lot of trimming on the plate. Now I've got the profile I want. Again, you have to make sure you keep in mind that there is a finite amount of clay here. You have to keep in mind the angle, the shape you want to make your platter, and the amount of clay you're working with. I do want to undercut it because when it's glazed, I don't want to see where the clay ends and the glazing starts. So if that's undercut and in shadow, you don't see. Again, this is a dark clay, so I'll be firing it with a dark glaze. And then I'm going to define where I want the foot to be. And this clay in the middle, I'm just going to take it off by putting the little toe of this Kemper tool in and then putting the pressure on down to the heel and dragging it across the radius to hit where I want the foot to start. And now I switched, my elbow was on my other knee, but my elbows are still into my ribs and my hands are joined. Go at the speed where you're comfortable at the wheel. If it feels too fast, it is. If it feels too slow, it's too slow. The higher the pitch, the thinner the clay. So I am just about done trimming this guy. Just going to take a look at it. It looks trimmed with my sponge. I'm going to wet it. Trimming, you open the clay up and you can see where the trimming ended and the throwing starts. By sponging it, you bring the little particles back to the surface of your piece and you seal it. When you seal the clay and you can't see where your trimming started and your throwing ends. Just looks nicer. I think a pot should look as tidy and as completed on the bottom as it does on the top. I don't sign a pot at this stage. I like to sign them when they're dry. I wet them with a sponge and then sign them at that point. It also gives you that one last look at it before it goes in the kiln. You see any fingerprints or an oddball of clay or something, it's one last minute to tidy it up. If you go over and sign them when they're dry, they just have one last check. I will stamp it with Out of the Fire Studio and Alberta, Canada, so we know who made it and where it came from. And then I'm going to put it on the board it was thrown on. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put paper under it. The paper, if you put this just on the board, it will stick to the board in drying and very difficult to get off. And it won't shrink if it's stuck to the board, and the edges will shrink and it will crack and it becomes unpleasant. So if you put this layer of paper between your pot and the board, it sticks to the paper because the paper is wet, but it releases very easy from the paper once it becomes a little bit drier. So I'm going to put this on, and then I'm going to flip it over, and I want to tidy up the edge. Okay, we've got this flipped over without incident, and now I want to release it from the big bed I trimmed it on. And if you lift it up, it'll stick, and then it can stick or it can come off. It can come off halfway, and you'll ruin your piece. If you gently tap, it will release. You can hear it release. And then lift it up evenly. You don't want to lift it up. It's a fairly big bat. If you lift up one side, it's got quite a bit of weight. It'll push down the other, so lift it up evenly. And now you just have an area here where it touched the throwing bat. And sometimes you capture in smaller plates a little bit of air here, and this will pump up and it won't dry properly. So if you just lift it gently and push down in the middle, it gets rid of any air that's trapped in there. Now I'm not even going to worry about centering this because I'm just going to tidy it. And we can all see it's not centered, but if you concentrate, it's not that weird. So I want just to spin it off. I left the handprint on there when I was showing you. I don't like any handprints or fingerprints on these. And when you trim sandwich between the two bats like I do, you can do you can do all your sponging and not touch it and not leave messy fingerprints. Okay, now this is trimmed, and I trimmed this one a couple days ago, and you can see that it's dried. It still hasn't turned color, but it's quite firm, and it just releases from the paper. The paper sticks to the bat, but not to the pot, and then you can pick this up. Drying this now that I can pick it up and it's firm enough to handle, I'll put it on some baker's racks that are totally encased in plastic, and I'll dry it very slowly. The rims are the smallest amount of clay, and they want to dry first. If they dry first and become immovable, and the bottom hasn't dried, and the bottom wants to shrink and the rim won't give, you'll either have warping in the rim this way or just a big crack in the rim that way. So to get rid of the cracking, you want to dry it from the bottom and the top very slowly. So that's trimming the platter. That's trimming the platter.